Good late Tuesday evening. I am certified meteorologist Nick Kelly checking in once again on this September 17th of 2019. Thankfully, we kept things nice and quiet all day, but again, it was hot and humid. We'll have to put up with this for a few more days before we finally start to see a change in our weather setup that not only will allow better rain chances to work in, but finally a chance to scrub out some of this heat and humidity. Let's take a look back at where we've been throughout the course of the day from Indigo Sky just outside of Seneca, Missouri. We had another quiet day all across the area with skies bouncing back and forth between partly to mostly sunny skies. Even though it looked nice, it definitely felt like a late summer day with another hot and humid one. Normally we should be topping out around 82 at Joplin Regional Airport, but today quite a bit warmer than that. Afternoon highs around 93. And normally on our Wednesday, we should be seeing our normal highs dropping back to 81, but we'll be hot and humid again, with afternoon highs going back into the lower 90s. So we'll stay hot and humid tomorrow. We're going to stay hot and humid for your Thursday with maybe a stray thunderstorm or two trying to pop up if the heat and humidity that we see during each afternoon can get intense enough to get a shower or thunderstorm going. I'm seeing, though, better rain chances picking up as we get the weekend underway and with our next front working in as well. That will also help us trend cooler as we head into next week and as we kick off fall on Monday officially. It'll still be warm, but it'll be a nice change of pace instead of dealing with more of this, quite frankly, oppressive heat and humidity for mid to late September around here. Looking at 7th and Range Line late on this Tuesday night, we're looking nice and calm. And again, the official numbers don't lie. After we started mild at 70 this morning, we had a hot and humid day. Highs around 93. Keep in mind, we should be starting a day like this around 59 degrees in the morning and then topping out around 82. So we have a ways to go before we get back even close to normal, but I think we'll start to work our way there once we get past the next few days. 77 at last check at Joplin Regional with the dew point of 68. Still makes it feel a little bit muggy. Makes it feel like we're close to 80 degrees outside. That's how most of the area is faring, at least around the Joplin Metro, 75 in Miami, 76 in Columbus, while Neosho checks in at 77. But a few areas outside of the Joplin Metro, we are seeing 73 in Parsons, 74 around Grand Lake, and 74 down in Jay, Oklahoma. Thankfully, we'll join those areas and seeing our temperatures dropping back eventually into the lower 70s. We can thank the sky staying nice and calm tonight, and in fact, even starting out mostly clear going into Wednesday morning. But like today, won't be long before we warm right back up. In fact, we'll be back to about 88 once we get to noon or lunchtime as we head to the Wednesday. The SkyWatch Storm Tracker has been very quiet across the area today. Any thunderstorms close by were mainly confined just to the south of the St. Louis area around Cape Girardeau, St. Genevieve, and let's say Perry, Missouri, just along I-55. If you wanted any better rain chances close to us, you had to venture south where we actually had, briefly, Tropical Storm Imelda quickly form just offshore of the southeastern coast of Texas, but now it is working over the state of Houston as we head into the late night and Wednesday morning. It will continue to gradually weaken as it continues to provide heavy rain chances for a good portion of southeastern and eastern Texas over the next few days. Other than that, we are still seeing this upper-level ridge in control over the central plains for the most part. That also explains why we were hot and humid again. But we're still watching not only one, but two upper-level lows swinging across the Pacific Northwest. That will eventually get their act together and finally get this cold front to the west to start working on in. We're actually going to see the leftover moisture from Imelda working first before we see the cold front roll in. So that increase in moisture will result in maybe a stray storm tomorrow and a few thunderstorms on Thursday. Maybe better rain chances on Friday. But it's when that front rolls in as we get the weekend underway. That is when our rain chances really start to perk up across the area. We still have a ways to go before those better rain chances get here. So we're going to stick with a mild start to your Wednesday morning. Thankfully, we'll get a little reprieve from the heat and humidity. We'll be dropping back to mainly the lower 70s across the area, but then we'll waste no time going back into the heat and humidity for Wednesday afternoon. With partly to mostly sunny skies and the heat and humidity in place, can't rule out a random thunderstorm again, but for most of you, you'll stay dry. And everybody's just going to be hot and humid. 71 to start, 88 by noon. We'll have afternoon highs around 92. Keep in mind, with the humidity, just like today, it's going to feel like we're either in the middle to about the upper 90s as we head into the peak heating of your Wednesday afternoon. We'll just do it again for your Thursday. We'll see temperatures drop back to about 70 or in the lower 70s for Thursday morning, and then heat back up into the lower 90s. But with increasing moisture from what's left of Imelda coming in from the south, we'll see partly sunny skies and a slight uptick in our thunderstorm chances for your Thursday afternoon. But it's when that front out west finally begins to work in, even starting as early as Friday, that is when we'll see better chances for scattered thunderstorms pick up. In fact, I think the better shot for cloud cover and rain kind of looks to be Saturday and Sunday as we head through finally our last weekend of the summer season. And speaking of which, with the system, this doesn't look like it's in a hurry to move anywhere. In fact, this will still be hanging around the area as we head into the first day of fall on Monday and early next week. As long as that remains a part of the forecast, you can see what that does with the seven-day forecast. We'll hold on to the rain chances going into next Monday and Tuesday, but we'll be grateful for this system because it'll finally give us a chance to scrub out the heat and humidity. We'll go back to 92 Wednesday, 91 on Thursday, morning lows each and every day in the upper 60s to about 70 degrees, but Friday is when we'll finally start to see temperatures drop. 82 on Friday, near 80 for Saturday and Sunday, and then looking a lot better once we start fall. Early next week, we'll have highs remaining in the lower 80s. Have a good night. Have a great Wednesday.